Hello, this is Krillian. Welcome to episode 9 of my Let's Play Total War Warhammer 2. We're playing the Pirates of Sartosa. You just brought a full, pretty awesome looking army into here. Well, we'll go back to Lothair. Because you also dropped Ball's Anvil to size 3. Making it really not useful. We'll grab that because it's possible the High Elves would declare war on us. And we begin raiding their homeland. Like crazy.
Ready. Blow it sky high. Your orders!
How did you not get it? Oh, you must have... Did you go up to the army? That's terrible.
Yes!
Come search this. Oh, look,
my
they're
skills
escaping.
Increase.
Oh, I said that before I saw they were escaping.
See,
I'm
master.
Sure there are many people who are deeply surprised by the presence of escaping.
Crew, salute your betters!
The next thing.
Fleet Captain!
Oh, you can't get it. I wonder if I've somehow maxed out. That doesn't seem right. Doesn't seem right. I don't think you can max out on coves. That would make no sense. So we're just gonna sit right here and raid them while throwing gifts at them at the same time. Ignore me raiding your lands. Here's some money. Totally not doing anything shady. Totally not. Mace Saffrey is still around. I'm also amazed that they took back Magra, but they did not take in
and destruction.
Their other stuff. Sure, grab that. That's great.
Ready the lever! As my power ascends, Dreadfleet, sail! Boost these floating battlements!
An
impressive and bloodthirsty minion.
Nope. Sure, that one's fine. I really have, like, nothing.
I hunger for blood.
Can you get this?
Blow it sky high.
Okay, so I've not somehow maxed it out.
I hunger.
Sure you do. A deep hunger to be useful.
Aim for their stores.
You...
Buccaneer of the dead.
Okay. Does this tell me how much we'd get? No. Okay. I should probably be watching my homeland to see, but if no one declares war on me, it doesn't matter. Order of Lore Masters is not too powerful. Oh, they confederate with Tor Elisor. Interesting, interesting, interesting. I wonder who's winning the Vortex campaign. It doesn't really matter. I don't know if you have to. In theory, you shouldn't have to finish yours before they finish theirs. Think, because that would just be kind of ridiculous since they don't tell you and you can't affect the Vortex campaign. You also don't end up at war with them all.
10,000 lashes. On my way. Be calmed for now.
Bring it to there.
Onwards!
You are level 22. Get that useless spell. Okay, you...
Reach souls and coffers!
5 turns. We have a damaged building? Oh, Aminar must have struck. There goes the outrageous amounts of money that I had. You know, don't bother replacing that one or this one. Fix that one, and that one. The rest of it can repair over time. It's fine. If things get bad, I'll just do that and not care about the enemy. I don't want to lose all my money. That seems like a bad option. A bad, bad option, if ever there was one. I should come find this dude and wreck him. Cause I feel like you are a terrible person. Just a thought though. We should probably be going faster, I guess. Okay.
Waiting.
They don't seem to be bothering us. You
astride the waves. We'll send a message.
The mouth.
All powerful sorceress.
Interesting.
Armed and ready.
You
not possible. Astride the waves.
Don't care about that.
The world.
This will put me up quite a bit. I'll throw some gifts at them when I'm done raiding. I don't really want to go to war with them. That really wrecked their army. But it really messed up the... It took out the other army, so I guess, you know, wreck yours, lose the other one. It's a thing. We are more powerful than the Pirates of Sertosa, which is just odd, considering they have so many cities. They should have more than one army. So unless they're all just mobs, in which case I don't understand how the High Elves totally wreck them. We acquired a ledger covering much of the recently raided area, filled with information about shipping routes and cargo inventories. Two targets appear particularly valuable, yet strangely, they're undefended. There's only time to pursue one. Well, we're pirates. We're going for the
merchants. Count Noctilus reigns.
You.
Loyalty like
I really
this
want you to become high enough level that you're immortal.
Burn the coastlines!
Yeah, we're just sitting here. How are you doing on this? 25 after this. You know, I think this is just boring to me. I have to just push and turn 3 times real fast. We're making 8,000 turn. That is a stunningly large amount. So when did the sacrifice to Methlin? Isn't that the get another one? Yeah, Black Ark. Another Black Ark. You know, more power to them. Cause I don't care. The Stone of Cain rests. I've not gotten this Sword of Cain at any campaign yet, so I don't know exactly what it does. We'll go with that, because we have a ton of them.
Crew, salute your best blow it sky high! I hunger for blood!
Try not to die.
Course plotted. Voyaging.
Okay, you. No one's bothering you. We are massively weaker than Lothairn. Which means Sartosa should not have any of their lands. They should have taken them all. I don't get it. Unless they're somehow allied with Sartosa now. Which seems really poorly controlled by the computer, they are. Theory rating does get me money. And the ward save. Sea legs, serrated harpoons. How bad is it? They are kind of repairing. Public order is not great, but I don't care. There's Troll Fjord. Ooh, an Albion. Some people thought, I think Albion would become its own faction, but it did not happen. It did not happen. At least I think that was one that people thought might be its own faction. Maybe it will yet. I do expect one more DLC faction for this before the next Warhammer comes out. But you never know for sure. Could be the last. Okay, we've done it. The empty hall of booty was obtained during Noctilus's raiding, but Captain Ross' medallion continues to elude him, finally following a boarding action against an Empire raiding or trading vessel. During across the great ocean, a clue is found, a map supposedly leading to a treasure chest in which the moon die was last seen. Noctilus examines the map closely. He feels like he is looking at one of his own traps, but nothing is going to get in his way. The map might lead him to the moon die, or perhaps to someone who knows where it is. In any case, Noctilus will crush anyone who opposes him. Okay. Need to pause, I'll be right back. Okay, we're back.
Swashbuckler!
You can hit this just.
Blow it sky high!
Oh, you can't. You. You've hit level 20. You get that. You cut that
this
out.
This serves my cause.
Okay. I think we made more money leaving.
10,000 lashes.
You.
Off deck! Move!
Go to the Star Tower.
For the ship!
Okay. So now we can build this. It's doing fine. And we paired two of them just to cut back on the rate at which our stuff is leaving us. And Lothairn did not attack us or declare war on us for the raiding. We'll have to look at diplomacy. Maybe we'll throw some money at them in a means of keeping them happy. And then... ooh, we're gonna go do that battle. We didn't look at it. Probably should have. But I'm 20th level, halfway to what I want to be to go into the thing. Although I kind of would like my hero to be 40 as well. Although he doesn't have to be. He takes less than 40 levels to max out all of his yellow line. So once he's maxed out his yellow line, we'll be good to go. And, you know, the few things he needs above it, like immortality. Yeah, we're not gonna go to war with random factions. Yeah, minus two is not a big deal. They'll repair themselves. You. I do have a few things. We need that. Might as well have that. And that, because why not? I get that one. Power stone. You know what? Get this scroll of shielding. What does the power stone do? Hey, go with the scroll of shielding. Okay. Next turn he'll have those, and then we'll be ready to do our things.
You'll do you. The death. Aim for their stores.
Grab that.
By hook or sword, they'll fall.
We already have Mistar, but we don't have the other one. And then.
Makes sense, Admiral.
Cool. Go in and do our things. Almost all taken care of. I am kind of surprised more random factions haven't declared war on us. We had Harganath declare war on us, and then they never did anything about it. And eventually they just sued for peace. I think they paid for it. But that doesn't matter. No!
I thirst!
We're gonna wait a few turns for that to happen. Who thought there would
are
be a game there? But you didn't see
be
that.
Be gone!
You, whatever, get a mention. Who would have ever thought Skaven were there?
Declined. Wave treading.
Ends justify means. Go, Reaver!
You come to there and do that. You come faster. I just want to see the high elves in diplomacy.
Tyrion. I despise you and all that you stand for. Speak. Very well.
I don't really want them to declare war on me. There, that's much better.
I feel the maelstrom.
The 30,000 is unimportant. Not having to deal with fighting, although we would, you know, level off of beating their armies. But not having to worry about dealing with Lothlorien is more valuable. Because they have... whatever Sartosa was doing has apparently stopped working. They're like, we got you now. And Sartosa's like, oh, yeah, you do. Yeah, you do. Quarter by Varus. Without the player being here, a lot of facts
are... Ascalius Graven calls for more dead.
Okay, how long do we have? Two more turns.
No,
we don't
want to
do our special mission until then. That'll be great. Should last for longer than what we have. We're looking for pirates. You know, there's a map for that. They're all this direction. We've killed two.
Privateer!
Ew.
Aim for their stores! Salty blood!
Ew.
We'll send a message. Aim for their stores!
Here we... we're just gonna do this because I don't expect Albion Dash to be worth a ton.
Fleet Captain, reporting!
But I don't really care. We get tenacity. I mean, Sartosia still controls a ton of territory. If Lothlorien is this powerful, why have they not just walked over Sartosa? Like, hardcore walked over them. Oh, what can we do? What wonder. Holy cow, someone's a trade agreement? Sure. I paid money for it, but I have nothing better to do. Someone actually wanted to trade with me. That astounds me. We'll go with this one. Nothing but death. Okay.
Buccaneer of the dead.
On land.
Come that way. You.
Navigating. Power bides its time.
And that's the last one of those. That'll improve our range.
Lubbers! I'll lash the stragglers!
How bad is this going now? Oh, it's now positive. So it doesn't matter. Is there something that's improving public order? Whatever. They are repairing them on their own. We prevented revolt, which is the only thing that would have been annoying. Now we're gonna go hunting down the other pirate groups. Working our way towards the 8. Or we'll do this battle. Which might be against a decent crew. I'm so disappointed that I had to raid for five turns. I think five turns. Raiding is just such a pointless thing. If you want to go mess with someone, you can conquer their settlements and make way more. So sitting there raiding is just so pointless. Okay, we've improved our harpoons. Should I grab that one?
I feel the maelstrom.
Okay, doesn't look like I have any of the penalties anymore. So the Captain Ross medallion. Ooh, rocket batteries. That's actually a pretty vicious looking army. They're not hugely experienced. You land.
Raise anchor. Unliving skin does
and
not burn easily.
It's a terrible item, but we'll go and do this. Yeah, it's much closer. They are semi-experienced. Well, let's do some of this. You're getting the ward save. I don't want you to crumble.
I demand utter annihilation.
Okay. Now the Heststorm batteries mean that I probably am going to need to move forward. They could be a problem. The map that came into Count Nocta's possession is no trap. It has led him to an uncharted island in the Great Ocean where the treasure chest containing Rossman and Moondial is located. As he approaches the island, Halbert appears his map is the only one in existence. A large army of treasure hunting soldiers of fortune has somehow found its way ahead of him and pitched camp on top of a hill. Before the day out is out, Noctis will surely have made yet more of the dead to rise into his undead ranks. Not really. We really don't have too many of them. It would be really good as if some of these guys hit, you know. These guys are up to 7 chevrons. And that's what we're looking for, is everyone to be in the 7 chevron range. This should not be too hard. We do have to... I think we're going to pause, because it makes you... And we'll be right back when we get to the battle, because it always has that start button now. Okay, let's jump in and hear the speech.
The peons of the Empire dare lay their hands on the chest I seek? These cattle are ignorant of what they now possess, but they will not live long enough to find out. Roth's Moondial cannot elude me any longer. It is only a matter of time before another rival uses it to gain access to the Galleon's graveyard. Only I, Count Noctilus, am worthy of the Maelstrom's boundless power! Only I can rule the Great Ocean and the waters beyond! We will succeed!
Okay, do you think it's kind of poor that you... Okay.
Top crew!
You guys come like that. You come like that.
The plan? We move.
Yeah, like that. Yeah. Wolfram. I don't know why they're going up there. They can't get down to me. I guess their missile batteries make that kind of viable. You need to come over this way. You come forward as well.
Hold in action! Advancing!
Let us start dealing with what's up. Hard to get to those guys on the upper ledge, but we lost 50 men, which is pretty good considering this. Consider this a pretty decent fight for us. You did not get your next chevron. They're up to four, up to 4 to 5. And these guys are not yet gold either. We'll pause and be right back. Okay, we got 1,284 gold, and we have leveled.
Some souls are worth more.
I will take replenishment.
Come, no.
Losing units would be poor. We got more experience, which is great. So we got up to 22nd level. We have the curse.
Infamy.
A gallows giant. Eh. Eh. And this is just a dumb item. I get to summon a unit of deckhand mob. My campaign movement range is a little faster, so I guess that's something. But really, that's
death
a pretty pathetic
and item. Destruction.
Do that because I need to level up. This is not what I want. Running Prometheans and Colossus. Doesn't help dragons. But we're not going to get the one for Terror Guys because it doesn't do enough. It only helps one unit. We will get this. That is worth getting, I think. You know, I'm gonna hold off on getting that one for him because the melee attack is decent. Weapon strength, they already hit really hard. Magic resistance is not great. Instead, let's get the Curse of Undeath that will heal whenever he casts spells. We'll work on getting him some spells up.
A lethal blow!
He's leveled again. Get that. Improve that, or get this, which gives us more random bodies to throw into a fight, which isn't a terrible idea. You.
Loyalty like this is demanding.
You did not get a second one. In theory, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14, 17, 20. So I need to be low 30s, basically, for you to have everything I want. Well, it's been about two turns here. Leveling, and then I can move on. Making sure we're doing what we needed to do. We got the one critter, our legendary guy, but I don't really care about that one, so I don't know if I'll bother to get him. Instead of having like a giant range gun, he has a flamethrower, which does absurd amounts of damage, but it doesn't have a very good range. And I really like them for the long range firepower. It's where they get a lot of their kills. Why are you not going faster? Someone else has started the... They're right. Maybe it's keeping... I haven't done any of the Skaven campaigns, mainly because they don't really seem all that interesting in faction. They have some great cannons and stuff, but overall, they lack faction stuff. Okay, you're gonna spend another turn here. So
salute your betters! Good!
Oh my goodness, who would have thought there was Skaven in those ravens?
Armed
area?
And ready! Declined!
No, you can't do it, but hey, you're immortal! So no more fear of you randomly getting assassinated.
Wave treading! Aim for their stalls! We'll send a message!
Cool.
Avast!
Got a lucky charm. How about our damaged buildings? Still pretty bad. We're getting about nearly 10,000 gold a turn with an uber expensive army. That is pretty impressive. I do think this may be our last end turn of the episode. It's we are coming up on 40 minutes. We've been doing pretty long episodes in this campaign. Maybe I'll do one more. We'll look and see how our health is. I think I'm ready to come back and go to sea. The other pirate forces are... Oh, they attempted to assassinate my dude! Oh, okay, no, never mind. Their Mongol attempted to assassinate Anne. I don't care about that, whatever, she's immortal. She'd come back home and just start doing it over again. Okay. You're fine. My garrison is fine. We're all fine.
We have the dead.
You're not who I wanted to see. You need two more turns. I could just pump those out, but I think we're gonna end the episode here. So, real briefly, looking at our pieces of eight, we have that one here. That gives running mutants. That gives mortals. That is who I want, the Blood Reaver Deck Guard. Deck Droppers, I don't care about. And Deck Gunners, I don't really care about them either. So, we're gonna be aiming for this Stone of Schwarzhafen. Captain Sissiko, the Terror of the Dark Straits. I did not fight her when I was messing around with the Sartosans. So, I believe it's an undead faction, but that's not all. So, we're gonna end here. We'll be back next time for our hunting for the various pirate groups and just hitting everything en route to getting our guys up to 20th to 30th level. Yeah. So, anyways. Adios.